الرسول فأولئك مع listen to the words الذين أنعم أنعمت اني فاتحة in this one أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا who are they? They are or one quality whoever obeys Allah and his messenger will be among those whom Allah has bestowed his favors upon. Who are they? An-Nabiyyin, the prophets. As-Siddiqin, the truthful ones. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Maryam, the mother of Jesus, Mary, the Siddiqa, Aisha as-Siddiqa, bint as-Siddiq. These are the people, those who believed in the truth in the ultimate sense. And it guided them in their lives. Wa-Shuhada includes the martyrs, those who die in the sake of Allah, and the scholars. Because Allah says, شهد الله أن لا إله إلا هو والملائكة شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم. Allah bears witness that none is worthy of worship but Him. So do the angels and the people of knowledge. والصالحين and the righteous people. This is the only level which we can really be qualified to join, unless one of us becomes a scholar somehow. But if we don't make it to the scholarship, then at least we need to belong to the صالحين. We need to be righteous Muslims. Really righteous Muslims, inwardly and outwardly. In our behavior, conduct, speech, as much as we can, we will not reach perfection. But these are the ones whom Allah has bestowed His favors upon. Right? And these are the great. These are the great Nuh, Ismail, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, alayhim salatu salam. These are the people, the messengers, the prophets, Allah's chosen creation. We need to love them, imitate them, resemble them, live like them. We will be successful. Now, it's amazing. When you say that, it almost appears that this is sufficient, right? However, Allah continues to specify that not only we should ask Him to guide us to the path of these people, but we want to avoid another path. غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ Other than the path of those who have attained your wrath, your anger, and those who are misguided. Adi ibn Hatim asked the Prophet ﷺ, who are those who have attained Allah's wrath? He said, the Jews. He said, who are those who are astray? He said, the Christians. Why? Because the Jews had knowledge and they didn't act upon it. They knew Prophet Muhammad was coming. It's in the Bible, in the Old Testament, Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 18, and other occasions. It's in the Bible by his name, Muhammadim. In the Torah, by name, Muhammadim, his nose prophesied. But they don't believe it. Some of them came to the Prophet. They told him, we bear witness to you in the message of Allah. He said, what prevents you from entering into Islam? They said, we're afraid of our people. I mean, these people knew, but they didn't act. The Christians, on the other hand, they got lost in the process. They were led astray because the truth was not available for them at some point in time when they introduced so many innovations. And when the truth came to them, they became like the Jews. They didn't want it anymore. No, I mean, if you were to elaborate with any Christian concerning the reality of Jesus, whether He's a God or and the Son of God or one with the Holy Ghost and God in the Holy Trinity, and you try to get some logic out of it, you will get absolutely no logic. No logic. You cannot understand. They may not even understand what it really means. You have better understanding than they do. Because you know this is incorrect, you see? So this is how they became straight. So subhanAllah, you ask Allah to the straight path, then you ask Allah, we don't want the path of those who have knowledge, but don't act upon it, and know those who are ignorant. You know, they hear, أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِشْهَدَ حَبِيبِ What is this? This is dalal. This is deviance. This is misguidance. This is not from the sunnah. This is not from the deen of Allah. This is homemade. You know, nonsense. People worship Allah by kissing their thumbs and rubbing their eyes, and I don't know where these things come from. But these are examples, you know, examples of misguidance. People try to worship Allah with no knowledge. No knowledge. We have to stick to the dalil. We have to worship Allah based on an evidence. You have an evidence, it's authentic, Bismillah. No one would say anything. But just following our forefathers and our culture, wallah, people back home, brother, back in X country, this is how we do it. That doesn't mean anything in Islam. Who cares what people do back in there? Back in X country, people worship graves. Back in X country, people, you know, claim that Allah is in the creation. That doesn't mean it. It's just because the people say something, we follow it. So we need to be adhere to the Quran and the Sunnah. So we will not imitate the Jews who had knowledge which they didn't act upon, nor will we imitate the Christians who are worshipping God supposedly without knowledge, without knowing who God really is. Ameen, which means, O Allah, accept. It is a Sunnah to say this after the Fatiha. In the Hadith of Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned that if the Imam says Ameen, then say Ameen. Because if your Ameen coincides with the Ameen of the angels, all of your previous sins will be forgiven. So that there are four things. The Imam should say Ameen. Tell this to those who say you shouldn't say Ameen out loud. Because he said, when the Imam says Ameen, say Ameen. How are you going to do that if you don't hear? Durr. Then he said, you say Ameen with him. In order to coincide with the angels who say Ameen, then your sins will be forgiven. So it's a Sunnah to say Ameen. This is Surah Al-Fatiha. Very briefly. Books are authored about this. In the tafaseer, you go on and on and on and on with breaking down even way beyond what I gave you. This is all in Surah Al-Fatiha. This amazing chapter of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which deals with all aspects of Tawheed. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, by saying Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, Iyaka Na'bud. Tawheed of Asma' al-Sifat, the Tawheed of names and attributes of Allah, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. It reminds you of the Day of Judgment. It reminds you of the objective of life. You are supplicating to Allah to guide you to the path. You're asking Allah's aid and assistance. All this in this small chapter. Seven verses. Then let me conclude this lecture with this beautiful narration in Sahih Muslim from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where of hadith of Abu Hurairah, where he said that Allah azza wa jalla said, and I quoted this last time, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصْفَيْنِ وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ. Allah says, I have divided the prayer, the Fatiha, between myself and my servant into two parts. And my servant shall have that which he is requesting. فَإِذَا قَالَ الْعَبْدُ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى حَمِدَنِي عَبْدِي. If the servant says, oh, praise is due to Allah, the Lord of everything, Allah will respond to you and will say, my servant has praised me. If you say, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah will say, أَثْنَى عَلَيَّ عَبْدِي. My servant has extolled me. If you say, مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ, Allah will say, مَجَّدَنِي عَبْدِي. My servant has glorified me. Allah is answering you. You know how honorable that is? If they put your name in the newspaper, you can't sleep at night. Right? Oh! Saudi Gazette, man! That's my name! Oh, please! Brother, come on now! Criminals are put there every day! There's nothing special about you being in Saudi Gazette or any other. I'm not trying to pick on Saudi Gazette, that's the first thing that came to mind. FYI, the lectures are advertised there. Sakullah khair, Brother Umar. There's nothing special about that. So when Allah says, my servant has praised me, has extolled me, has glorified me, this is a big deal. Right? If you say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ, Allah says, هَذَا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلَ. This is between I and my servant, and my servant shall be given that which he is requesting. If you say, إِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ, Allah will say, هَذَا لِعَبْدِي وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلَ. This is for my servant, and he will be given that which he is requesting. You see that? Every time we recite the Fatiha, we are having a conversation with Allah, where you don't hear the other end, but you believe. So this is why it is not befitting to say, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik, Yawm al-Din, Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in, Ihdinas Siratal Mustaqim, as many of the Imams, let alone the Ma'mumin, do. Because the ulama say, have adab, mannerism with Allah. When you say, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, and Allah responds to you, what are you saying? What are you rushing to? The Prophet ﷺ used to recite the Fatiha ayah, ayah, a verse individually. He did not link